Hello, good morning, everyone. Thanks for coming. Let us check your audio reception. Do you see that guy with the raised hand? You can click on the down arrowhead beside this icon and then click on agree if you can hear me. All right, so we have with us Christine May Torres, Sir Francis Molina, and Sir Mark Luis Fernando. Try po natin yung audio niyo, sirs, and Christine. Okay, so Christine says our audio is okay, and she also has a microphone with her. So Christine, would you like to say something?
Hello. Anything?
Let's try your audio also. Hi, that's good. We can hear you. All right, we're waiting for some people. I think they're logging in to KaSaMa Teachers First. So let's give them some time. At least 18 have signed up to join this morning's webinar. So, antayin lang po natin sila ng konti. Meanwhile, you can try our whiteboard. You might want to type in your name and draw something on the screen to show us how you feel. You can choose from the shapes toolbar, tools there. Okay, so let me start Celia and let me do some shapes. And put some colors. There. Yeah. Hey. Okay, so you can try our whiteboard tools. So, ah, kaya, yeah. Your audio right now is not stable, so minsan naririnig kita, minsan hindi rin. Okay. Oh, so Mike is drawing. Wow. Ano to? Bundok.
Sino kayo madalang laptop?
Waiting.
Ma'am Jeng, dala mo laptop mo? Dala mo laptop mo?
Okay, so you just explore the toolbar.
Ma'am, paiwan saglit. Uwi muna ako. May webinar kasi ako ngayon. Ayaw mo mag-connect. Hindi ako makatay.
Ano ba yung pinagdo-drawing niyo? Sir Mart. Sir Mart, sali po kayo. Sir Fernando, sali po kayo. Sir, Sir Fernando, if you're using a headset and you have a microphone, you can set it up. So later on, if we have time, we will provide you with audio rights so you can talk also. Sino itong son? Si Christine siguro lumipat ng ano. Ay, she's back. Ano to, pagandahan ng drawing? Ah, okay, Sir Mart. Okay lang po. So, sali na lang po kayo dito oh, sa whiteboard. Yeah, I hope everybody has answered the poll on when we joined KaSaMa Teachers. May 2011, May 2012, May 2013, May 2014. Also, lahat na nandito ngayon members na. Okay. Tignan ko lang yung mga friends natin sa KaSaMa Teachers. Baka po merong mga pumasok doon. Si Marco, ginawa talagang canvas yung ating whiteboard.
Yan na po yung gumagawa ng farm.
Ay, ganun? Ay, oo nga, no? O, binubuo na ni Jan. Oo, nagko-collaborate na tayo dyan.
Dagdagan ko na lang ng...
Ako, gagawa ko ng bird. Dadagdagan ko yan ng bird. Subukan ko makagawa ng bird. Yan, oh, isang uwak lang yung dinagdag ko. Yan, may isang uwak akong dinagdag. Hindi ko na kaya yung iba. Ah, dapat may river din yan. Diba? Dapat may river dyan na pinagkukuhaan ng tubig. Pang irrigate. Parang hindi ko kayang gumawa ng river. Gagawa na lang ako ng balon. Yan dyan, oh. Banda rito, may balon. Yan. Balon ng tubig, yan. Siyempre, may katawan yan. Yan, yung blue na yan, parang ellipse, eh, balon dapat ng tubig yan. Imagine ninyo na lang balon, balon ng tubig. Parang kulang yan pang dilig dun sa mga halaman ni Jan na palay. Pang-inom na lang yan pagka nauuhaw. Aba, nasaan na ang ating mga kasamang teachers?
Ano pa? Yung kwan ho, yung selection sabi niya, yung pinaka leftmost po na icon. Tapos yun po. Papa. Tapos after nun, okay na siya.
Okay, so there's just one more member who logged in to KaSaMa Teachers, and I've already given her the link to join the webinar. I think anytime soon she'll join us. So let me formally start the orientation this morning. Welcome everyone, especially to Christine May Torres and also to Sir Mark Luis Francis Fernando. Magandang umaga po sa ating lahat. Alright, so I hope naririnig po ninyo ako ng malinaw where you are. Okay, so today's orientation webinar is actually the second we did for KaSaMa Teachers. Okay, so I'd like you all to meet the team. We are the host of KaSaMa Teachers webinars, and we also serve as the community admin for KaSaMa Teachers online community. So, Mart, so you also have our faces. That's John there, Mike, Dulce, and myself. Okay, so let me see. We've started the KaSaMa Teachers in UP NISMED, but I know that it's all over the country now. So would you like to type where you are from or where you're joining us from right now? Please use the chat pod to type your town or city and province. Okay, so Christine is from Longapo, somewhere here in Central Luzon. Oh, and Sir Richard also has just joined us. Okay, so okay, so we're all here from Luzon, no? I hope our friends from the Visayas and Mindanao will be able to join us in a while. So nandito tayo lahat, no? Sa north, si Sir Fernando. And somewhere at the middle, ay sina Mike and Christine down here. And also Sir Richard from Manila. All right. So, well, let us know a little bit more about yourselves. What grade level and subjects do you teach? Those of you who are teaching right now or will be teaching this coming school year. Please again type your answers on the chat bar. Okay, so meron pang mga pumapasok. Grade 6 or 5 for Christine, and also grade 7. 9 and 4th year high school. Bah, marami-rami ha. Marami-rami yung preparations na yan. Oh, and Mart here is doing, well, advising, no? Research and investigatory projects at St. Louis Center. So chemistry teacher dati si Mart. So tamang tama, no? Next year when you pass the LET, malaking asset ka sa high school teaching. Okay, so we move on. All right, so let me show you one poll here. Let's see. We're talking to three of you, so let me adjust the poll right there. Okay, so kindly answer our poll. Are you a member of a professional organization? For example, biology, Teachers Association of the Philippines, or MathEd? One no and one yes. Okay, so our next poll. Let me hide that now and bring up a new one. This time, there. What about online communities? Have you had experience joining any? Could be purely social networking, could be professional, or could be both. All right, so both Christine and Mart are members of social and professional online communities. That's good. So ibig sabihin, marami na kayong experience, no, or background about communities online. Okay, so, well, what have you been hearing about KaSaMa teachers, if you're just new or now that you've been a while here in the community? What do you say KaSaMa teachers is? Please type your answers on the chat pad again. What do you know about KaSaMa teachers? What can you say about KaSaMa teachers? What do others say about KaSaMa teachers? Okay, so providing updated resource materials for science. Okay, that's how KaSaMa teachers have served. Some teachers or Christine's own experience. Teachers helping teachers. Oh, that's nice, Richard. Teachers helping teachers. Have you helped any teacher here or have you been helped here in KaSaMa teachers already? Or do you know of anybody who has helped a fellow teacher, or who has been helped by a fellow teacher? I think we all know some. Okay. So for Mart, it's his graduate school classmate who introduced him or introduced KaSaMa teachers to him. And so this is a perfect opportunity to learn a little bit about it. And as you've said earlier, you've already browsed the site, so you have some idea, no? Okay, so thanks, Christine, for promoting KaSaMa teachers to the teachers you've trained. Oh, si Sir Richard Gant. Then, ano, narinig din niya from, during the one seminar he has attended. Alright, so, well, let's start getting to know KaSaMa teachers. First of all, we need to set the targets of today's webinar. It's an orientation webinar, yes, and the focus would be the following. First, this is an opportunity for members to get together. It's just unfortunate that not so many are joining us today, no? Although a lot have signed in or signed up in the webinar. Unfortunately, I don't know, some technical problems or last-minute conflict may have prevented them from joining us this morning, but definitely this is a get-together, I think, for those of us who are here right now. This is still a good occasion to assemble as a community, and we would like to also for you to go away after the webinar with an appreciation of KaSaMa teachers as an online community. You know, some would look at it as a website, but you'll find out later on that it's more than just your regular website. And then, as members of the community, you'll be able to list up, you know, a bit some examples or ways that you can engage in the community, contribute content, ideas, and opinions, as well as help grow our online community of science and math educators. And then, of course, you can add, what do you think? What brought you to the webinar this morning? You can type that in the chat so we can include that as the objective of the webinar as well. If that's not yet included in the upper three objectives. Okay, would you like to add your own objective? Or are you happy with these three? This is a get-together or a meeting or a making connections with other members. And then understand KaSaMa teachers as an online community. And then identify ways you can get engaged and contribute to the growth of the community. Okay, so looks like you're happy with the three objectives. Let's move on. First, we start off with the idea of what for us is a community, you know, why is KaSaMa teachers a community? I like this simple definition of what a community is from the Community Roundtable group. The Community Roundtable is a community of community managers. So it's in itself, it's an online community that helps communities as well. So this is their definition, that a community is a group of people with shared values, behaviors, and artifacts. So the idea here is that the key are group of people with shared values, behaviors, and artifacts. So let's remember that as we continue on with the presentation. The community is not the media per se, no? It's not Facebook, it's not Twitter, it's not MySpace, it's not even podcasts or forums or profiles or videos per se. So it is not the media. Instead, it is the people and the relationships that they build around each other. So when you talk about communities, you think of, or you see people making discussions, you see people making connections, then you also know that there are some passion to do certain things together, that these people also support each other and continue to network, and there are maybe some smaller groups in it but the networking continues, and there's definitely a lot of collaboration going on. And then members or these people also share their own voices. And in many cases, they just don't stop with the relationships. They go move forward having their own shared mission as well. So this is something that I'd like us all to think, start thinking about KaSaMa teachers as a community. And let's look at this slide. I like this slide very much because this shows in a rather vivid way what the difference is between a website, a regular website, and an online community, you know. So tignan ninyo yung sa kaliwa, no, the content network, there are no crisscrossing of lines. And the circles here may represent even people, but mostly content or resources. Walang meeting, no? But if you look at the community, the circles can represent content that are related to others, but this mostly represent the relationships or the interconnections among people. So the main difference between a regular website would be that it focuses on the, your regular website can focus on content alone, provision of content. So people go there, download content, or people go there to share their content. But there is no relationship about other content, and definitely no relationships are expected among the persons behind the content. But in communities, the more important thing is the relationship, not just the sharing of content. And I think this is one thing we would like every member in of KaSaMa teachers to use as a lens when looking at the KaSaMa teachers as an online community. All right. And so with that in mind, with the background that we are no regular website, but an online community of people with shared mission, with shared resources, with shared values, let's look at, take a look at the KaSaMa teachers. This is going to be a quick overview of what you already see in the site. But as we do this, I'd like you to focus on two things. First, as we do the quick tour, I'd like you to think of what you can do in KaSaMa teachers as a community member. And then also think of what we can do together as a community. So titignan po natin, no, as we understand or as we go through the different features and the functionality of our KaSaMa teachers site, let's think of again what you can do, what we can do together. Okay, so now you have another new address, another online address. That's http://kasamateachers.ning.com. So you are also here in this address. All right. Again, this is the landing page. When you click on that, you can also click on that separately now. I will not do it, so I don't steal your bandwidth, but you decide. You can click on this to get to KaSaMa teachers if you want. Okay, so we have another one who's joined us just now, Catherine Alvarez here. Welcome, Catherine. All right, so if you look at the KaSaMa teachers landing page or main page, what do you see? What attracts you? Can you list two of those items? So you have there, of course, our official logo. And then there are some subsections there, as well as sections also found on the tabs. So you can choose two of these. And again, please type your answers on the chat pod. What do you see on the main page of KaSaMa Teachers? Please choose two and type them on the chat pad. Okay, so, well, Mark said it's events and discussions. Okay, so others are coming in. Also events and discussions for Christine. Okay, oh, well, I'm seeing more people joining us in KaSaMa Teachers. Nandun sila sa kabilang site, no? So maybe we can request John or Michael to please guide our participants there on the other side. Okay, so, oh, so Catherine is also from Malolos, Region 3 din. Events and discussions din. So, itong dalawa to ang talagang popular, no, sa ating mga participants. So, you have, what about si Richard? Richard, are you still with us? So, events and discussions. Ang dalawang popular. Alright. So, let's continue. Tignan natin, no? The reason, one of the evidences that KaSaMa Teachers is really a community is that you need to first register and set up a profile before you are officially accepted as a member. So, naalala nyo pa to? You needed to fill up some form when you registered. So, may mga tinanong dyan, tungkol saan kayo nag-aaral, nagtuturo, the subjects that you teach mainly, your address, number of years of teaching, and so on. No? So, in yung unang-unang proof that you are joining a particular community, no? Your registration and this, the profile that you set up. And then, of course, aside from that, the community would require you to add a photo of yourself. No? So most of the time, marami pa rin ngayon, no? Mga nakikita natin itong figure na nasa kaliwa. Ito siya. Ito. Yan. Maraming mga kamukha yan. So how do you feel talking to this person and this other person? Yan, siyempre malaki yung pagkakaiba, no? Ito, ang isa, yung nasa kaliwa, marami ang kamukha. Alright, so one of the things you can do very quickly if you have not done so yet in the community would be to locate your user box up there on the right side of the main page or on every page that you visit. And then, just click on the settings. Makikita ninyo yung settings, no? Yan. And then you can, of course, add your own profile picture. Mas maganda po talaga na kamukha ninyo, hindi yung nung baby pa kayo o marami kayong kasama na hindi man ma-identify kung alin doon kayo, no? Requiring you to include a profile photo is really personalizing a bit more the experience. This is online community. We don't really talk in person, but having a picture of somebody you can associate a name with is much more engaging than interacting or conversing with people who are faceless, even online. All right? So I hope you can find that. The time to upload your own profile picture in KaSaMa Teachers. Again, aside from having a picture, it's important that in a community, people know who the members are and what kind of background they're coming from, what kind of subjects or in what grade level are they teaching. So it's important that you tell others that you are here, because if you notice, you may have a profile that's hidden. You may also have a picture that's hidden, but unless you participate, like reply to a discussion or start a discussion, nobody knows that you are in the community. So you might be a member, but no one knows that you are unless you introduce yourself. So it's important that you let others know that you are also in this community. And one good way to do that is to reply to the discussion thread titled Who's in Our Community. The link is right there at the bottom. So you can visit that later on, of course, or just find Who's in Our Community among the discussions list. And you see, you have two people here. Oh, well, that's fortunate, very fortunate. Christine is right here also. And then there's one teacher here, one member, Jesma Garcia, who introduced herself as a teacher of San Roque High School. I think this is still part of Bulacan. And we're happy that Christine welcomed her. No, so I'm not sure if they know each other personally, or si Christine ay talagang nag-serve as a welcomer or a greeter to the member who introduce yourself. So again, it's important to have a profile picture and to introduce yourself to the community. Sometimes we see people introducing themselves to the community by replying to this discussion thread, pero faceless naman sila, no? Yung mukha kanina na nasa kaliwa, yun naman ang nakalagay na mukha nila. So parang wala ring silbi, no? It's not so meaningful if you introduce yourself and nobody will see a face to associate with your identity. Okay, so next. So first you have a profile picture, you fill up a profile form, then you upload a picture, and then you tell people that you are part of the community by telling them about yourself. And then of course you can also check out who else is in the community, no? Kasi dito, this is just no website, no ordinary website. Na yung people you see there are only the ones who are developing the content or the system administrator, no, or the web master. Hindi lang yon. In an online community like ours, like KaSaMa Teachers, you see a lot of people, and there's one good way to check out who else is in the community, no? So you can click on the members tab there. Above the fold, and if you click that, you'll be able to see some of our featured members, the ones with pictures, and then you see all others down here, no, sa ibaba. Yan. Why are these people featured? Why are these members featured? These are the ones who have uploaded their photos and also introduced themselves by replying to the Who's in Our Community discussion thread. So, kaagad-agad, pag nagawa nila yon, pini-feature namin sila at yung mga mukha nila ay lumalabas doon sa front page ng community. So, if you haven't done those yet, gawin na po ninyo para ma-feature na rin po kayo. Definitely, the members who have introduced themselves but have not uploaded pictures, we did not feature. Kasi, para paano mo if i-feature yung isang faceless na member, di ba? So, wala rin added value yon. That's why we don't. So, again, recall that you can look up other members of the community. Baka may mga kakilala na kayo dito, mga co-teachers nyo, mga dati nyong teacher, o dati nyo, o yung mga estudyante nyo dati are also in the community. Okay. So, if you find somebody who you're interested with, you can also check out the details, no? You can get acquainted with that member. So here is an example. You have Tam Chu here. We just covered some of the details about him for privacy's sake. And then, of course, you can message him. Yan, pwede mo siyang i-message. And then you can also view his more detailed profile and request that you that he be your friend or you be his friend. No? So you can add him as a friend, or you can, and then when he accepts your confirms your request, you will see that appear in his latest activity in his profile, and you will see your picture among those in the list dito, no? Okay, so that's so easy. Find other people and check what their profile is. For instance, if they teach the same subject or the same grade level, there might be a good opportunity to network with him or with her. So make use of that feature here in KaSaMa Teachers to make friends. And then, of course, one other thing actually about KaSaMa Teachers are the conversations. In fact, historians of communities or online communities attribute the beginnings of online communities to discussion forums or discussion boards, no? So dun talaga nagumpisa yon, no? People talking to each other about things that interest them or things that they care about, no? So here in KaSaMa Teachers, that's also one of our main features. In fact, that's one of the things that you've chosen earlier, no? What you think is important, the discussions. So you can join conversations. Sometimes people are not so familiar, they're not so comfortable joining discussions or conversations if they have not known personally the people. But again, as you stay on a little bit here in KaSaMa Teachers, you'll be able to find out that it's possible to converse with people you have only met online. So how do you do that? If you click on discussions, you'll be able to see a list of the discussions, including those that are featured. I will not do that right now, so I don't steal your bandwidth, but you can definitely do that on your own computers. You can click on discussions and find one. And then, for instance, if you find one, what do you see? If you just click on one, you'll be able to see the full text of that discussion topic. And then you can click on reply to this. There's this box right here. And you see the text that says reply to this. That's where you type in your reply, your answer, or even more questions you can ask to clarify what the poster actually wants in his discussion. All right, so that's one. You can join a conversation, and that's very easy to do. And then, of course, if there's a topic you want to talk about yourself, or most of the time our members are asking for help, no? Or there are some things they need to clarify, to be clarified on, they start a conversation or they start a discussion. So what do you do? How do you do that? You just click on discussions again, and once it appears, you just locate this button here. Ito pong my plus add na button there. It's usually at the right side of the page that shows up on your screen. And you can just click on that. And once you do that, you will get to see this discussion page. And you can add your title right here and then your post. And then, of course, you can add a category. What is this about? Is it about the curriculum? Is it about laboratory? Is it about teaching strategies? Or is it about textbooks and other curriculum resources? So you can define the categories. Defining the categories actually will help others later on to find discussions about a specific topic or group of topics. And that's going to be very, very helpful for you and for them as well. And then you can add your tags or your keywords, so that when people search, other members search conversations on specific topics, they can use the tags. And then when you think it's important that you show some files or documents or graphics to support your question or to make clear the point you want to focus on in your discussion, you can also upload files that other members can read. This can be something very helpful for you. And then, of course, if you have a Facebook account, you can click share on Facebook so that it goes into the news feeds of all your friends in Facebook that you have done this, that you have started a conversation or a discussion in KaSaMa Teachers. And then you can choose also first to preview your discussion, see how it looks, because you can, of course, format it. You can add links to it. You can add images to your discussion body. And then if you're happy with the preview, you can already click on the Add Discussion button. And that's it. You've started the conversation. One thing I'd like to encourage you is, of course, to make sure that you follow this page, the discussion that you've started, so that anyone who replies to it, you get a notification if anybody replies to it. And that's an important tip for you. Hindi ka pabalik-balik, no? Each time somebody replies to your discussion, you get that notification email that somebody has replied to your discussion. We will be probably in the near future, we will be doing a webinar that focuses solely on tips for how to moderate discussions, how to create discussion topics that will draw in a lot of responses. All right? So we will be sharing those tips later on with you. And what are our most popular discussions at the moment? They're all associated with K-12, of course. We have posted as a discussion the webinar resources for grade 7 right here. So you see all the recordings and even the interactions among teachers as they share their experiences about grade 7 science also here. Actually, this is a link, so you can, if you click on this, you go directly to that discussion thread. And then the other one is, of course, the grade 8 science webinars, no, resources and discussions. Meanwhile, most of these are just the resources that people want to download in relation to the webinars for grade 8. And then there's another popular one about K-12 assessment here. This was started by Paul Magmanwa, no, who was asking for tips on how to go about the assessment process in K-12 program. All right, so again, let's see. What discussion topic would you like to do in KaSaMa Teachers? Ano kaya ang magandang topic to discuss about? Meron ba kayong tanong, concern na palagay nyo ay mas magandang itanong dito sa community, no? Because actually, the community has the answers. Oo. Subukan po ninyo. Try natin. Lagay natin sa chat pod. What discussions do you think or conversations you'd like to do? Tignan natin, anong topic kaya? Ano kaya magandang diskusyon na umpisahan or salihan? Okay, so some people are starting to type. Hintay natin, no? Anong magandang topics for discussion? You'll find out that when you visit KaSaMa Teachers, medyo marami-rami na rin yung mga discussions na nandun, no? Actually, I think we have already let's see, about 55 forum discussions already in KaSaMa Teachers. Meron na tayong ganun kadami. Okay, looks like may naisip na kayo mga discussion topic. I see you're all typing. Okay, so improvisation of materials. Ang kay Christine and Sir Mart says, how can schools upgrade the products of investigatory projects without proper and necessary equipment, reagents, chemicals, etc.? Oh, this is a very interesting question. Maganda. Subukan mo yan, Mark. Mart, you can start a discussion on that. Actually, you can also connect that later on. Meron po kasing isang webinar this coming June. I think it's going to be the second webinar for the elementary science. Ang focus ay investigatory projects or investigatory activities for grades 4 to 6, I think, elementary. So maganda din sigurong ma-raise din yan, no? What else? Oh, there are still people typing. Okay. Okay, so looks like meron kayong naisip na kagad, no, na iba to dito sa community. Some things you consider are important and you'd like people to contribute their experiences, their ideas, their resources, their strategies, etc. And I think yun nga, no? Yun ang talagang kinaiba ng isang community kumpara mo sa ordinary website. There is very little interaction sa website, one way lang, no? Kung ano yung nandun, basahin mo, download mo, yun na yun. Pero you can talk back to those pages while you do here in KaSaMa Teachers. Okay, si Sir Richard naman, ang gusto niya, integrating technology just like this webinar in teaching digital learners. Oh, we have a lot. Richard, you can join the teachers and you see a lot of links there related to how you may be able to teach yourself, no? About those topics. All right. SIT webinar. Okay, sige, we'll think about that. Oh, that's a good idea. We'll note that. Grade 9 learners module, more detailed activity walkthroughs. Okay, sige, subukan natin. We've actually planned to do a grade 9 science, no? Science webinar series again this coming school year, and there's one going to be in June. We will see how many of these activities we will be able to present as walkthrough sessions for these activities, depending on how many of the writers we can invite. No, we'll accept our invitation for them to be webinar presenters. That's just like we did with grade 7 and grade 8. For our NISMED writers. All right? So, mahirap po kasi yung mga grade 9 writers, hahanapin po talaga natin sila, no? Because we don't know who they are. We just know, I think, at most two of them at the moment. But we hope to be able to answer that need, Catherine. All right. So, mukhang kailangan talaga itong mga ganitong events, no? A lot of your suggestions have also to do with your professional learning, no, or professional development, and you hope that our online community, KaSaMa Teachers, can provide you that at the moment. Constructing, understanding types of assessments. Very popular itong topic ito, no? Paulit-ulit itong hinihingi talaga sa ating mga discussions doon sa KaSaMa Teachers. Okay, so these are some things you can discuss about, or we can plan about to work together on in KaSaMa Teachers. All right, so let me continue. Of course, the discussions are asynchronous. No, you don't need to be talking to each other face to face. I mean, real time. You can just view the discussion and then you can reply anytime. But there's this also very nice opportunity to interact real time with members. Ako, madalas kong ginagawa ito, no? If your KaSaMa teacher's website is open right now, you can switch to that window and then see that at the bottom right, dun sa malapit dun sa may taskbar, sa ibabaw lang, nandyan yung na, kung sino-sino yung mga members na online. Members online, you see them right there. No, makikita nyo nandyan sila, mga names. And then you also see the main room. If you click on that, makikita nyo nandyan yung mga notes or announcements for everybody. And then you can use this room also to chat. But then if you want to talk to one particular member, what you do is you just click dun sa right side, sa dulo ng kanilang pangalan, no? And then you see that if you click the down arrowhead, you'll be able to see view profile, start chat, or ignore. Yan, yan yung mga pwede ninyong makita. So, this is what I do usually. Nagbabantay ako kung sino yung mga pumapasok, tapos ini-interview ko sila, gine-greet ko sila, ini-interview ko sa sila. So, maraming mga opinions, ideas sila, tsaka concern sila na they're shy to share publicly, no? So, hindi sila nag-start ng discussion. But you can interact with them real-time using the private chat feature ng KaSaMa teachers. So, this is where I also get a lot of information and feedback from our members, no? They're more generous if you do this private chat with them. Yung exchange kasi medyo personal, no? It's not supposed to be known to others at parang hindi masyadong risky, no, for some. Some people might be uncomfortable sharing their ideas on public discussion thread, like the ones I've shown you earlier, but they're more comfortable just chatting privately, no, in this manner. Kaya lang, sometimes, pagka tinatanong nila ako sa mga ganito, ini-encourage ko rin sila, no, that they also start a discussion so that other people who have the same concern or may offer help and solve their problems that they've raised in our private chat, nagko-comply din naman sila, no? Marami sa kanilang mga nag-start din ng mga discussions. Or some of them also have posted blogs as a result of this private chat, no? So, maganda din, take advantage when you're online to see also who other members are online. Then you can start interacting with them, no? Minsan, no, informally lang. Kasi there's just no way you can make use of our online community if you don't communicate and take the initial step to talk to people. And this is one very important way to do it and a very easy way to do it. No? Minsan, umaabot ako ng 2 oras, kakachat lang in with one member. But again, I gain a lot from their experiences, from their questions, and from their concerns. No? We just hope that these private chats can really go more public so that a lot more will be helped and will be guided as a result. Okay, so again, remember, so you can do the conversations and then you can do the chat. It's just that you need to find out kung nasan ito, no? Minsan may nagsistart na conversation, di mo alam na chinachat ka na pala, no? So watch out for some blings, things, and sounds there na lumalabas minsan sa inyong mga computer. Yung pala meron ng gusto makipag usap sa'yo online. Alright, so again, some people would make use of online communities like ours for professional development. And so far, this is an area where KaSaMa teachers has actually gone a little more forward, no, in providing our members with the webinars that matter to them, especially those that relate to K-12 science in particular, no? So we have done a lot of webinars since 2012, starting off with an overview of the K-12 curriculum and then also of the grade 7 science walkthroughs, very detailed explanation of each learning activity in each module for all quarters. That's what we have done so far. We've done webinar series for grade 7 and for grade 8. And then in those webinar series, it's not just the writers who have served as our resource persons. In fact, we have teachers whom we have invited because of their sharing in KaSaMa Teachers to also share as webinar presenters their own experiences in implementing the different activities in the learners modules. So they're telling us, they've told us stories of their own classrooms. So again, well, we are lucky to have with us here Christine May Torres, no? Christine May was one of our sharers, no? Our presenters in a webinar that focused solely on sharing of implementation experiences. And I think Christine shared about, I think was it the last module in grade 7? I think it's about Earth and Space, if I remember right. Again, as part of the webinar and events here in KaSaMa Teachers. So you see, many can take advantage of the professional learning opportunity here in KaSaMa Teachers. And the webinars and events are examples of those. So if you see, we have a lot lined up for June this year also, no? Na mga events. We also announce here conferences, public lectures, and stuff like that. Most of the time, if they're, all the time, if they're webinars, we also record those webinars for people who miss them but would like have to know what took place in the webinar. All right, so this is where you get it. You click on the webinars and events tab. That's one of the things listed earlier. I think it was Sir Mart who chose events. Well, everyone else. And then you can see the lineup of upcoming web events and webinars. So you can actually look at also the past webinars if you wish and see what the topics were, and you might be able to find a way to answer some of your professional needs. No? Baka may na webinar na dati na ganun yung topic. It might be a good material for you to review the recording. And so you get a list of all the upcoming events when you click on webinars and events. But aside from that, all right, when you open KaSaMa Teachers on the landing page, you see just below the list of the featured members. Bago nyo sa ilalim no, no, you see this box here, events, yan, makita nyo. Nandyan din nakalista ang some of the upcoming events. And then, as an example, ito, nasa kanan, this is the list that shows up in the main page. So you have several, no, for June. I think we have at least 5 for June. We have 2 more which we have not included here yet, the announcement. But I think we're doing 5 or 6 next month. So medyo busy tayo sa webinars next month. Okay, so just be sure to know where you can find the webinars and events, announcements, and how you get to one of them. All right, so that's again very easy. All you need to do is to click on that event or webinar announcement. And then once you're in the page, you can tell or signify acceptance of the invitation, or you sign up to attend the event. All you need to do is just locate your RSVP box and then click on will attend. Some of you express their willingness, but they're not sure about the schedule, so they click on might attend. But just as well, we hope that those who clicked on might attend can actually attend. Okay, so this is very easy. Look for events and webinars and events. Choose one that you're interested in and sign up using the RSVP box. And that's very easy. And sometimes if the event is a long way in the future, you get privileged communications or announcements if you have signed up using this RSVP process. No? Pwedeng nakatanggap pa kayo ng additional email or special resources that are provided only to those who have attended the event. Okay, so this one is about the international conference that will take place in October. I hope you've seen this or find time to see this or get some more friends to look at this announcement and then RSVP. We take care of updating you about the event if you do that. All right, so it's not just the people announcing the event in public that you can avail of. You can, in fact, also organize your own event here in KaSaMa Teachers. Be sure that it's a public event and it's related to science and math education. Or you can also announce an event, a public event, that members might be able to, might be interested to attend or can actually attend. No? So pag open siya sa public, open siya sa mga members, na hindi lang yan limited sa inyong mga eskwelahan or sa inyong mga communities, but it's open to everybody, you can announce those events right here. And how do you do that? Again, you just click on the add button. Ito lang palagi, hanapin niyo lang palagi itong si add button na to, no? And then you get to see this window or this page on your screen. You add the event information. You can even upload an image or a logo of that event if you want. And then describe it here. Do your description very well so that it attracts people and tells people exactly what the event is about, what is expected to happen, what will be the benefit if they attend, and so on. Okay? And then, of course, you specify here the date and time. And then you can also define if the announcement is going to be made public, meaning anyone can RSVP and see the event details. And then right here at the bottom, you can also identify or specify a website for that particular event if you have one. Otherwise, you can link to a Google map so that people will be guided how to reach the venue of your event. And then if you're ready with all the details, you can even specify who is the organizer. If it's not you, then you just put here, like UP NISMED, or the name of your school, or your organization that will run that event. And then if you're ready with all the details, you can click on Add Event. Later on, you will have the opportunity to edit. If you want to change some, the description maybe, or change the time, you can just click on the Edit option again on the page. So ganun lang kadali. Whatever it is that is happening related to science or math education in your school or in your community, in your region, in your division, you can announce that right here, no? And get people to see, may ganun palang nangyayari sa kanila, ang division, no? And that's, I think, a very good way to show people how alive science and mathematics education in the Philippines is, no? If we see those things that are happening in your respective areas. All right, and then Of course, sometimes it's good to know who the people are in the community, but then you know that there are some very common concerns or some resources that you'd like to share with a particular group. So you can find a group. Meron ba dyan elementary science teachers group? Meron ba dyan na mga grade 9 teachers? Meron ba dyan na interested sa technology? Meron ba dyan mga TEI? Yung mga faculty? Ang tinuturuan ay yung mga college? Oh, meron bang ganun grupo dyan? Baka naman mas maganda na meron din kaming ganun, no? So you can look up a group. Again, just click on the groups tab on the page. And then find a group. There's a featured group also. You can see that here. We have featured Hinayan. And all the other groups are also just below the fold. And right now, there are only 8 groups in KaSaMa Teachers. Meron ba kayong gustong salihang grupo? Or do you have in mind, saan kaya ako gustong sumali na grupo? Okay? Can you think of that? Is there a group that you think should be organized here in KaSaMa Teachers? Some people you want to be together with, aside from the big group, the big community? Meron bang ganun? Okay, so you can think about that and then just type it on the chat pod. Is there a small group, a smaller group you want to belong to here in KaSaMa Teachers? Can you wish there's an organization like that in the Philippines, for instance? Okay. A regional group. So you can organize one for CAR, for example, so that if there's a need to meet up face-to-face, you can easily talk to each other and say, kita-kita tayo sa Burnham Park pa? Sa Baguio ba tayo? O punta tayo sa ibang lugar sa CAR? No? So you can. That's a good idea. Pwedeng ganon. Kita-kits kayo, mas malapit lang. Pwede rin. Yes, per division. Why not? So, if you know some people who are already members of KaSaMa Teachers who belong to your region or to your division as suggested by Mart and Catherine, you might want to do that, no? Organize, find, start a group and then announce it and then say you can invite people to join. Okay, so of course it's easy to join an existing group. All you need to do is locate that join button again on the page and then simply click it, no? Tapos lalagay na lang naman ng mga details yan. And then your name will already, or your face if you have a profile picture, will appear right here. No, sa listahan ng mga members. You see the number of members, you see who they are, you can in fact click on each picture of the member and to get to know a little bit more about that member. And you see, nandito na naman yung mga faceless na mga members, oh. Yan, I hope we reduce them very soon. Gusto natin lahat may mukha tayo sa KaSaMa Teachers. Alright, so again, forming your own group is also easy, no? Click mo lang yung add and then you provide the details of your group. Here, the name, your purpose, the description. And that would be a good thing to see na ilagay din po ninyo kung ano yung gusto ninyong mangyari sa grupo. Anong activities ang gusto nyo? Anong goal ang gusto nyong ma-reach? Paano nyo gagawin yun, no? And of course, if you start a group, be sure na balikan mo siya kasi magmo-moderate ka ng grupo. Huwag mo mag-start lang tapos hintayin mo lang na may mag-join. Tapos paramihan na lang ng members, hindi ganun, no? You should have a very clear idea of why you're starting a group, what activities you can do with the members, what else you want to achieve within the community, and how your group can help fulfill the mission of the community. Diba? Oo. So, paminsan-minsan puntahan din ninyo yung group nyo, iti-welcome ninyo yung mga bagong nagdating at bagong sumali, no? Oo, wag yung, hey, mas marami na, gusto ko mag 100 members, pero pinapabayaan mo naman, wala namang nangyayari din sa group. Diba? So, bakit pa kayo nag-group, nag-subgroup? Okay, so, yun lang, importante, when you form your group, you should be able to moderate your own group as well. And then you can set features here, like, can they add comments? Can you send messages to everybody? And then, sino yung pwedeng mag-join dito? Pipiliin nyo lang ba? O iimbitahin nyo lang yung gusto nyong sumali? Or anyone who's interested can join. So, you can set up those details within your group. Alright, so, yun na. Tatapos na natin yung groups. Now, it's time to look at one other option you can do. What you can do in KaSaMa Teachers. I've seen profiles of our members. Marami sa kanila yung may background sa journalism, no? Magagaling magsulat. Naging advisor sila ng mga school newsletters nila or papers, school papers or organs, publications. And even during their high school and college days, mga nasa journalism ang kanilang mga co-curricular activities, no? So this is a good time and a good opportunity also for our members to do that, no? If there are some discoveries, some reflections, some new learnings, and even some issues they'd like to raise, you can write it up right here as a blog or as an article, no? Madali lang din gumawa. And then of course you can attach files to support your case if it's going to be one like that in your own blog. So you can do a persuasive blog, you can do a critique, you can do an informational blog if you want, and many others. And by the way, hindi po pala kailangan English yung mga entries dito, ha. Pwede niyong isulat yan sa Filipino or isulat yan sa inyong mga local dialects or languages. Hindi kailangan English dito. If you're more comfortable expressing yourself, whether in the discussion, in the chat, or elsewhere, kahit sa announcement ng mga events, pwede niyong i-Filipinize yan. Hindi kailangan English, no? Wala tayong restrictions in terms of language here in KaSaMa Teachers. Okay. And of course, madali lang. Isa sa mga easier way to participate in KaSaMa Teachers would be to comment on a blog. Or pag ayaw mo mag-comment, medyo tipid kang magsulat, na pwede mo na lang din i-like, no? But we hope that people who like would also be able to comment so that they can tell why they like or which part of the blog they like, no? Kasi maraming mga points din naman na re-raise minsan ng isang blog. Hindi mo alam pag nag-like, ano kaya ni-like niya? Pareho kaya kami nang ni-like, no? So it's good always to write a comment, no? Describing. Would be a good exercise also to practice our skill in composing paragraphs or in sentences. Magandang activity din yan, actually, professionally. Right? So, that's as far as the blog is concerned. And of course, you can contribute your own. Meron kang gustong na din i-express, no? There are some new discoveries, some learning, some reflections. You've attended a conference, you've attended a training. There are some things you want to note and write about and get people to read and know. So parang ito yung boses mo eh, no? Boses ng bawat isang miyembro. Sometimes we're not heard, sometimes there's no opportunity to do it orally, but you can always write it anytime. And you have now a bigger audience, no? Yung buong Pilipinas na science and math teachers na to. So you develop a very strong sense of audience. and you get also a lot of people to give you feedback about your ideas and your experiences. Again, you can preview it first or just save it as a draft if you're not sure yet. Save mo muna habang tinatype mo pa lang siya. And then when you're ready, just click on the, again, you can click on the publish or post your blog when you're ready. And then tell your Facebook friends that you have shared or contributed a blog to KaSaMa Teachers. That's going to appear also sa mga newsfeed nila about you. Okay, so let's pause here for a while. Tignan natin, what would be a good idea for a blog as far as you're concerned? Kung meron kayong isusulat dito sa KaSaMa Teachers, tungkol saan kaya yun? Okay, so please think about it now. I'll give you time to think about it and then type your answers on the chat pad. What would be a good topic for a blog? What would be a recent experience that you'd like to blog about? Okay. Maganda po yung suggestion din ni Christine, ano? The private school experience of implementing the K-12 basic education program would be something good to see in KaSaMa teachers also. I'm sure maraming magkakaroon ng magka-contribute, no, ng additional experiences nila dyan. Okay, so let me move on to our next one. This is actually our crowd drawer here in KaSaMa Teachers, no? Yung mga resources ng ating community, no? The most popular resources in KaSaMa Teachers are actually those that relate to the K-12 program. In fact, we see that many of our newcomers say that the reason why they or the way they have known KaSaMa Teachers is from teachers or trainers who have pointed to KaSaMa Teachers as a place where they can get copies or updated copies of these important K-12 resources. For example, the learners modules and the teachers guides. Okay, so we've lost some of our connection. Can you please tell me if you can hear me? Some of our connections here are lost, but I hope that mine is working. Okay, good. Thanks, Mart. Thank you. Okay, so again, let me just go back. No, these are the popular resources here in KaSaMa Teachers. Most websites would be websites where you get a lot of this content, no? Information, resources, content, those are their main purpose, while communities will focus on discussions and interactions. And on the side, provide resources as shared resources by all the members. This is not really the main thing about online communities now. But again, what is nice is that we know now for a fact that the need for particular resources can bring people together for them to organize and get together. No, I think that's very clearly shown here in KaSaMa Teachers. We know now how much need there is for these K-12 learners material and teachers guides and even the curriculum guides. No, ang laki ng pangangailangan. No, kaya people keep on coming to KaSaMa Teachers just to have access to these resources. And I think while that may not be the best way to join, the best reason to join an online community, at least we know that there is a shared need at the moment for those resources. And that shared need might bring people together. Okay. So again, these are examples of the most popular K-12 resources you have here. All of these that you see on your screens right now are linked to the resources. So if you click on any of these, like the K-12, for instance, the K-12 Science Learners Modules and TGs, the Math Learners Modules, and then if you want copies of the DepEd issuances and the curriculum guides, you just click on this to get to those pages in KaSaMa Teachers. Okay, so again, you've seen a lot of what you can do and what we can do together in KaSaMa Teachers. You've seen the community members, access to the community members. You've also seen the discussions, the webinars and events, the groups, the blogs you can write and contribute or comment to, and even the resources that you can access and resources that you can contribute yourself. Okay. The next question would be, how can you contribute? So let me just synthesize what we've been talking so far, no? These are what you see on the screen are suggestions on how you might be able to initially contribute to the growth of our community. You can be a greeter, like if you see people introducing themselves, you can welcome them. And then you can also develop content, like you can write up a blog or an article on a topic that you think other science and math teachers would be very interested or concerned about. And then you can also start up and moderate the conversations or discussions. Be sure to get back to them and thank people if they reply back. And then you can also start a group and moderate it as well. Or just simply join a group. And then you can announce or organize events. Okay? So there are a lot of options right now. I think what we hope that the orientation we provided you will be able to give you some ideas on how you might make your online experiences in a networking platform such as this one more professional, no, than what you've already done so far. So let me ask this question. What can you do in KaSaMa Teachers? I'm sure habang pinipresent natin ito, no, nag-iisip na rin kayo kung ano ba ang pwede ninyong gawin now that you know a little bit more about KaSaMa Teachers. You can type your initial ideas or initial thoughts on the chat pod. Okay, so let's see. Now that you know KaSaMa Teachers, the features, the functionality, as well as the objectives of the online community, what do you think can you start with? Okay, so Christine can promote, no, market the community in seminars, trainings, and opportunities. Right here in KaSaMa Teachers, how can you participate? How can you contribute? Given those features here in KaSaMa Teachers, what would you like to do? Would you like to start a discussion? Would you like to reply to more discussions? Would you write a blog? Would you like to participate in a group? What do you think you can easily do? Okay. So you can market. Okay, so Catherine also can do that. So you're very interested to do promotion work for KaSaMa Teachers, no? What about content? When you get into KaSaMa Teachers, what would you like to do? Would you like to participate some more in the discussions, reply to more discussions, for example? Or would you like to start a blog and so on? Is there something you can do quickly right now? Okay, so participation in discussions would be a good way to start. You can browse through the different discussions and contribute your own ideas, your own experiences, your own practices. That would be a great way to do it. Like there's one discussion about assessment, and then there's another one about science laboratories. Ano kayang itsura ng science laboratories natin? So that might be good to contribute also. Take a picture of your of your lab or your science corner and then share it here in KaSaMa Teachers. That way we kind of put together an album of science laboratories in the country. You can also help others who request for assistance, no? Yung mga baguhan nating mga members, yung mga first time silang magtuturo ng science or math, humihingi sila ng tulong. You can look at them as well, no? And share your own experiences. And maybe you can say, ako din, ganun din, kailangan ko rin ng ganyang tulong, no? Okay, so again, that's something that we all can do. So I think we can end here. There's just one little slide I want to show you before the feedback. This one. This is called the Community Engagement Standards. Are you familiar with this? The good, the better, and the best. What people are saying is that in a community, an online community like KaSaMa Teachers, for example, most of the time, 90% of the members are lurkers. Imagine, no? Lurkers ang 90%. So kung meron tayong 1,000, 900 sa mga to lurkers lang, sumisilip lang sila, bumibisita sila, basa dito, basa doon. Ayan, mga ganyan. O kaya pag nakatanggap sila ng notification sa email, i-click nila yung link, silip sila dito. These are people who do not want to make their participation public. Non-public ang kanilang participation. Silip sila, may nakita silang maganda, download nila, or ina-absorb nila yung mga nabasa nila, but they have not expressed their opinions or they have not made their participation public. So nobody knows that they're actually coming into the group, to the community. Makikita mo sila, nakalag-in sila, o kaya sa gabi sila naglalag-in, o kahit sa daytime, pero you can never hear them. No chat, no reply, no like. Mga consumer sila. So, ito daw yung rule of thumb. 90% of the members are lurkers, 9% are contributors. By contributors, ito yung mga nagre-reply sa mga discussion, ito yung mga nagla-like, ito yung may konti-konting comment, naglalagay ng comment, o kaya ito yung mga nag-a-ask na maging friends, ito yung mga nag-a-accept na maging friends, and only 1% ang creators, meaning these are the people who start discussions, these are the people who write blogs, these are the people who initiate groups, initiate activities in the group, in the community. So 1% lang daw. Ito yung rule of thumb, noon pa man. And then, there is this KaSaMa, survey. This is called the SOCM, the State of Community Management. And they found out that the better communities are those who only have a little over half their membership as lurkers. So, makita ninyo dito, mas kukonti itong mga gray, no, ng mga tao. And about 1/3 of them are contributors. So, nagpa-participate in one way or another. And a bigger percentage, 15% of them are actually creating content in their community. So, these are the better communities. Ito yung medyo buhay, no? Buhay na community. Itong una, siguro yung mga nag-create lang ng community ang nagsusulat dyan. Wala nang iba. Dito, you see some of the members are also contributing content. And what about the best communities? Those that really make a difference in the lives of their members, these are the ones who only have a very small portion of their membership as lurkers. More than half are in fact contributing content. Sumasali sa mga usapan, no? Sumasali sa mga diskusyon. And 26% of them, more than one-fourth, are creating content in the community. So these are the ones who really work. These are the kinds of communities that make a difference, no? So parang ito yung nag-online community at nagkaroon ng silbi. Itong better and best. Right now, dito tayo banda, hindi naman tayo good na 1% lang yung mga nagde-develop ng content, no? Nag-create ng content. At more than 9% naman yung mga nagko-contribute. But we really have a good proportion of lurkers sa ngayon. Mas gusto pa nilang pumunta ng KaSaMa teachers para mag-download ng teacher's guides, saka sa ng learner's materials, but only that. They don't look at, they don't read the discussions, they don't participate in discussions. They look at KaSaMa teachers as a resource center or as an ordinary website. They join and then they get a copy, they download a copy, and then they go away, and then they don't return. Or when they do return, it is because they received a notification by email saying that these are the new things, and then they click on the links. No, ito yung mga 90%. Sa ngayon, hindi naman tayo maabot ng 90% dyan. But we would like to move forward to becoming a better online community. Better in the sense that we are making sense and we're creating impact in our members. That's why we want more people to participate, no? So, yun yung gusto nating mangyari sana. Okay? So, any comment on that? Any ideas on this community engagement standard thing? I hope we can all, no? Kukunti lang tayo yung mga nandito ngayon. Only few of us have attended this orientation webinar, but I hope kahit kukunti tayo, dadagdag na tayo dito sa mga pula, no? Mga pula o kaya sa blue man lang. And then, when next time you introduce KaSaMa teachers to other people, you know how to introduce ourselves. You just don't tell them, oh, go there because they have a copy of the latest learner's materials or teacher's guides. You tell them it's a community. It's an online community. They need to participate if they want to be a member. Hindi kasi siya website. Di po ba? We're not a regular website. We are an online community. Okay. So, are there questions you'd like to raise at this point? If you have questions, you can freely write them on the chat and I'll try my best to answer them. And meanwhile, you can also share your feedback about this orientation webinar. The link is right there on the slide displayed. We would really appreciate hearing from you about your comments or feedback about the webinar. Ah, Sir Marto, thank you. You will not be a lurker. Oo. Yung mga lurkers, yun yung hindi pa nila alam kung gusto talaga nilang maging members, no? Pero sana makapag-decide na sila at mag-contribute na talaga sila. Mm-mm. Kasi kung lurker ka, you'd rather go to websites, no? Oo, not in an online community. Mas magandang website. Hindi mo naman kailangan maging member kasi pwede ka namang humingi din ng kopya. Follow mo lang yung mga links. You can attend webinars even if you're not a member. But what do you get if you are a member? You can tell people about your experiences, you gain reputation as a science educator, you participate in professional development activities that are only available to members, and then you get to know a lot more, you widen your network within the Philippines. Yan, si Ma'am Catherine, ano? Ma'am Catherine, I think, is a new teacher, she said. The beginning teacher. That's a lot to be, there's a lot you can share, actually, you know, to the community. And mga reflections, experiences ng isang bagong teacher. Yeah, marami yan. Kailangan, minsan, yung mga veteran teachers, we learn also, we revisit our mission as teachers when we hear from the experiences, the challenges, and the success stories that are shared to us by beginning teachers. Okay, so kindly complete the end of webinar survey as we are wrapping up very soon. We have been granted a 30-minute extension, but we will be wrapping up soon. So kindly, may I request you please to fill up the survey form. Ah, yes, I agree, no, Sir Mart. 21st century teachers are not only information consumers, no? We create information, we collaborate with people, because you will not be able to survive the 21st century education. You will not be able to support your students as they, well, as they find their way, and you cannot help them survive the 21st century if you cannot show them examples of participation, examples of collaborating with others, examples of solving problems with others, examples of sharing with others. Definitely. That's a very good point. Okay, so please let me know if you have completed the feedback form by typing, by indicating that in the chat pod if you're done. At baka meron pa po kayong mga gustong itanong din. There's a very good point here, no, shared by Christine, saying that I think we need to break yung language and grammar barrier. Kasi nga, yung mga iba ay shy kasi baka i-judge yung kanilang English, yung kanilang grammar, no? Totoo yan. That's why you see some of our blogs, the ones that Mike and John and I wrote about our tributes to teachers. They were all written in Filipino, no? So, pwedeng-pwede talaga. At hindi kailang malinis ang grammar at complete sentences. Ang importante na ko-communicate natin yung gusto nating sabihin. And in the process, learn how to articulate ourselves better. That would be a good way, one of the things that KaSaMa teachers can help. Yes. So we can show examples of replies that are written in Filipino. Sometimes I do that occasionally also. Kaya lang, nahihirapan din ako kasi hindi naman ako Filipino talaga, pero nagtatry ako, no? I think we can do that. Yes, I agree, Christine. We can definitely model that as well. Yes, although I would agree, I would still recommend that we maintain some professional level, kind of professional communication, no, in our sharings and in the community. Kasi that also would show how much parang courtesy din, no? In courtesy to people you're talking to. It would be good that you use a polite language as well. Sometimes if there's a need to provide slang content, why not, no? Pero again, nasa konteksto. Okay, thanks, Mart, for doing the feedback. Si Ma'am Catherine, tapos na rin, no? Okay, so would you like to comment? Please freely share what you think, either about KaSaMa teachers or about today's orientation webinar. Feel free to write your comments. Also, maybe if there's something I'd like to ask, it would be, what is your most important takeaway? Or what is your most important, what is the most important thing that you learned today from this orientation webinar? And I would love to hear that from you. Ano yung pinaka natutunan mo sa orientation webinar this morning? Okay, I see some of you are typing out your responses. Thank you. Right, Mart, I agree. In KaSaMa teachers, we really would like for this community to be able to support our science and math teachers to become very effective teachers, and not only effective but really outstanding science and math teachers. And of course, if we have outstanding science and math teachers through the community, we will be able to create a generation or even more of scientists, technologists, mathematicians for our country. Yeah, right. Oo. In the end, yun ang gusto nating mangyari, no? That all these efforts about improving and helping each other in the education sector will really redound to progress and development for our country and our people. Thanks for sharing that, Mark. Maybe you can write a short blog about the orientation webinar today, and tell the other members what they've missed by not joining. Ha ha ha. Oh yes, that's a very good perspective you've shared, Catherine, no? In fact, ang iniisip kasi ng marami talagang website ang KaSaMa teachers, but as we have said earlier, we are not a regular website. Ours is a community. We are an online community so that everybody contributes. The content that you see on the site are a result of peer input, not the creation of only a few, no? Yung website creator or web master, hindi gano, no? In the community, everyone has equal right to contribute content. That's the big difference of an online community versus a content website. Yes, and each member's voice, each member's experience, each member's practice is as important as everyone else's. Yeah, ganun talaga yung malaking pagkakaiba. If people look at KaSaMa Teachers as a website, ganun talagang mangyayari. They won't see the need to contribute. Kasi akala nila hindi sila pwedeng mag-contribute. But if they look at the KaSaMa Teachers as an online community, then that spells the difference. Iba talaga. So, I hope that the very few of you who attended today's orientation webinar would be able to introduce KaSaMa Teachers in a much better way, no? In a more accurate manner to anyone who would be interested. You tell them, this is not a website you can download resources from. Of course it is, but it is much more than that. You get to interact, you get to collaborate, you get to share as well. Yes, we are looking forward to reading and seeing your posts at least, no? At yung mga pumasok dito. This is a commitment we actually would like to get people, no? That's why we've invited, we've organized this orientation webinar. We really just hope we might need to redo this later during the year, maybe in the third quarter, to get more people accurately and appropriately informed about what KaSaMa Teachers online community really is. Okay, so folks, I hate to say this, but we are approaching our 30-minute extension deadline. We're 3 minutes away, and I would really like to take this opportunity to thank all of you for joining us. And I hope that with how many of you, 1, 2, 3, 4 of you have spent the time with us understanding KaSaMa Teachers as an online community, not just as a website. More people will learn about us, and we see more activity in the community site, more contents coming in from members, and more support showing up in our discussions for each other. Okay, once again, maraming salamat everyone for joining us.